If you want to know how to use the variable zigzag feature on the Janome 9450, you're going to want to watch this video because I'm going to show you how to use it. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst. I'm an online educator and I'm the creator and host of The Quilter's Way. It's the only online quilting club that allows quilters to grow and learn in a fun, supportive community. Now, before we get started today, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video. When you're using the variable zigzag feature on the Janome 9450, first you have to get into the right area to use it. So we're going to be clicking on that t-shirt icon and we're going to go through to where it says quilting VZZRW. VZZ being variable zigzag. You're going to press on that icon as well. And you can see there's several choices here. Now, this feature, variable zigzag, obviously is going to be doing a zigzag stitch, but you've got all these different choices. So what do they do and which one do we want to use? Well, this one, as you can see, the first one here where it says free motion M uses the PDH foot. And what it does is it's starting the zigzag in the center and moving out to either side. So you're able to actually adjust how far you want it to go. So the most, of course, is 9 millimeters, which can actually make that less. But what's happening is the stitch is starting in the middle and going out to either side. If you go to the L, it means left. It means the stitch is starting on the left side, then coming to the right, back to the left, and then to the right. So a little bit of a difference, but both of those can be done with the PDH foot. Then you have these options here. And you'll notice the screen actually shows a QV foot. You can use the QV foot for this stitch, or you can use the QZ foot, and that's actually what I'm going to be using in this video, just so you'll be able to see what the machine's doing easier. Again, you have the M option, where the stitch is going to be starting in the middle, going back and forth, or the L, where it starts on the left-hand side and goes out to the right and comes back again. Now, there's a few other things I wanted to point out here. I mentioned already that you can adjust the maximum width, 9 millimeters, but you can adjust the width of that zigzag down further, and there'll be a minimum as well, otherwise it becomes a straight stitch, or it maybe becomes a straight stitch. Okay, so it's down to zero. So you can actually have a little tiny zigzag if you want. It's going to look more like a straight line, really. Of course, when you get to zero, it's going to be a straight line. So we can take this up again. We'll go back up to 9. And if you find that you like it at less than 9 and you want to keep it there all the time, or you can notice here that I've got the tension adjusted. It's at 1.8 and it's yellowed out. What does that mean? It means I've adjusted it from what the normal setting is, and I'm calling that my favorite stitch. So when you click that triangle at the top, you'll see those in more detail, but you can see at the bottom the default and favorite stitch. So I had actually adjusted the tension. I found I needed to adjust the tension to make it work better to 1.8. And again, you can change it up or down, or you could go back to the default if you wanted to. Okay, just click that triangle to get out of that screen again. So for today, what I want to work with is I want to work with the free motion M using, as I said, the QZ foot. Either the QZ or QV will both work with this particular feature, with the variable zigzag feature. Now, when you're doing this, you're actually going to be free motion quilting. So you need to make sure that you drop your feed dogs, because mine are up right now. So you need to drop your feed dogs, insert the correct foot. So either, in this case, the QV it's asking for. So the little QV foot looks like that. Look at that, looks exactly the same. Okay, or if you went up to this one, you'd be using the PDH foot. So just to show you what that one really looks like, it's the closed one they're using here. You could use the open toe one as well if you wanted to do that. But let's go back to what we're actually gonna stitch with. So make sure you set up a free motion quilting, feed dogs down. If you wanna have a slippery surface underneath, I've got a slow slip. So slip two, always difficult for me to say, that I have there. You also have the option of changing the foot height here. So it's automatically set to 1.5 millimeters, but you could make it higher if you wanted to. So if you have a thicker quilt sandwich, you can make it higher. If not, you can just go and use the default, the 1.5. Of course, if you have a thinner sandwich, you can make it thinner as well, or closer to your quilt sandwich. Lower, I guess, is what you would say with the foot holder. Okay, so I can just click that OK, and we're back to here. So my machine is all set up. Of course, you need a quilt sandwich as well. So you need a piece of fabric on top, some batting in the middle, and fabric on the bottom. And there's one really important thing you need when you're doing the variable zigzag stitch, because you are going to be going back and forth. And even though you have a maximum of 9 millimeters as far as your stitch width, you can actually control how far you want it to go within that 9 millimeters. You can have it narrower, going wider, narrow again. You have that ability, and you're going to be using your knee lifter, and that is what's going to adjust that width as you stitch along. So make sure you've got your knee lifter installed in the machine. It just goes into the front of the machine. You'll see a hole. You just want to plug it in and it's good to go. So make sure you've got all that set up and then meet me back here again and we're going to work with the variable zigzag stitch. All right, so I'm ready to start. I like to bring up my bottom bobbin thread. Well, bottom thread too, I guess. Down. Okay, and so you've got a few things going on here. So it's like your free motion quilting. So you're going to be moving the sandwich with your hands. I'm not using my gloves right now because it's just a small little sandwich here. Change your speed. Make sure your speed is down slower. You want to start off slow and take it easy with this. But then you also have to use that knee lifter. Okay. So when you first start off, don't press against the knee lifter. And what's going to happen is it's actually going to stitch a straight line. Okay. Even though it's showing zigzag on the display menu, it's going to stitch a straight line. So let me show you what that looks like. Not very exciting, looks like a straight line. But this is where the fun comes in. It's when you start using your knee lifter. So how far out I press the knee lifter determines how wide the stitch goes up to 9 millimeters as the maximum, of course, that we can stitch with this machine. So I'm going to start stitching again, and then I'm going to start using my knee lifter and pushing it away from my body, pushing against it, and you'll see how it starts going into a zigzag stitch. Okay, so several things happening here. My foot is going on the foot pedal so that the machine actually stitches. My hands are moving the sandwich along, right? Because we're free motion quilting. Remember, the free feed dogs are not helping me here. And my right leg is pressing against the knee lifter to make that stitch go back and forth. Okay, so you can see, I turn around the other way. So when I don't press too far out, I get about this width. When I press all the way out, I'm getting that 9 millimeter width on those zigzag stitches. Okay, just one thing, I forgot to activate my automatic pressure foot lifter. Okay, let's try again. Okay, so looks like a heart monitor. But anyway, you can see as I go along that you can adjust the width of those stitches with that knee lifter. And so you can have a lot of fun with this, but what it's really good for is, of course, thread painting, because you do that and then you want to blend in. You would go in and blend in with other threads in here as you color that fabric. And if you were thinking of thread painting, well, actually, I'd like to know, have you ever done thread painting? And have you, if you have one of these machines, have you ever used this feature to thread paint? I'd like to know what tips you may have, so let me know in the comments below. And the other thing is, when you're doing this, you can see how slow I was going, but also you're noticing that as I go along, I don't know if you can see this or not, but as I go along, you might find that you even need a little bit of stabilizer underneath to avoid any tunneling. Certainly if you were doing this very densely, like a satin stitch, you might need to have some stabilizer underneath as well, just to make sure that that fabric doesn't shrink up and cause that bump in the middle. But that's what your variable zigzag feature does on your Janome 9400 or 9450. Thanks for watching. If you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to share it with your quilting friends. And remember to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video.